Question number 11. A company that uses Microsoft 365 plans to deploy updates to computers. You need to choose the appropriate update channel based on each requirement. Which update channel should you use for each requirement? On the left side, you have the update channels. On the right side, you have the requirement and you need to choose the correct update channel. The first requirement is provides the newest feature as soon as they are ready. The correct update channel is current. The second requirement is provides the newest feature update on a schedule. The correct update channel is monthly enterprise. The third requirement is provides the most amount of time to test feature updates. The correct update channel is semi-annual enterprise. Question number 12. You need to determine the lifecycle of products and features in Microsoft 365. What should you use? Option A, support.microsoft.com. Option B, Microsoft Lifecycle Services. Option C, docs.microsoft.com. Option D, Microsoft 365 Roadmap. The correct answer is Option D, Microsoft 365 Roadmap. Question number 13. You need to determine the release date of Microsoft 365 features. What should you use? Option A, Office Deployment Tool Release History. Option B, Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Option C, Microsoft System Center. Option D, Microsoft 365 Roadmap. Option E, Windows Insider Program. The correct answer is Option D, Microsoft 365 Roadmap. Question number 14. A company uses Microsoft 365. You need to identify new Microsoft 365 features that have released to general availability in the last month. Which tool should you use? Option A, Azure Portal. Option B, Microsoft 365 Roadmap. Option C, SharePoint Online Landing Page. Option D, Security and Compliance Center. The correct answer is Option B, Microsoft 365 Roadmap. Question number 15. You are the Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. You need to find all general availability features for SharePoint Online. Which option should you select on the Microsoft 365 Roadmap page? Option A, in development. Option B, rolling out. Option C, launched. The correct answer is Option C, launched. Question number 16. A company deploys Windows 10 to all devices. Feature updates to Windows as a service must be installed as frequently as possible. Which Windows 10 service channel install updates most frequently? Option A, Windows Insider Program Servicing Channel. Option B, Long-Term Servicing Channel. Option C, Semi-Annual Servicing Channel. Option D, none of the above. The correct answer is Option A, Windows Insider Program Servicing Channel. Question number 17. You are the Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. The company plans to upgrade client operating system to Windows 10. You need to explain the concept of Windows as a service to the management team. Match each term to its definition. On the left side, you have the terms. On the right side, you have the definition and you need to choose the correct term. The first definition is early build that are released to the public during the feature development phase. The correct term is Windows Insider Previews. The second definition is a method for controlling the frequency at which organization deploys Windows 10 features. The correct term is servicing channels. The third definition is a method of gradually deploying Windows 10 features by using multiple sets of targeted device. The correct term is deployment rings. Question number 18. You manage point of sale terminals that run Windows 7. You must upgrade the terminals to Windows 10. Terminals will not be upgraded again for at least 5 years. You have the following requirements. Perform consistent scheduling of upgrades across all devices. Minimize cost. You need to prepare for the upgrades. What should you use? The first question is Windows 10 version. The correct answer is Windows 10 Enterprise LTSC. The second question is servicing channel. The correct answer is long-term servicing channel. The third question is servicing tool. The correct answer is Windows Server Update Services. Question number 19. A company plans to migrate to Microsoft 365. Corporate devices run Windows 7 or Windows 10. You must upgrade all devices to use Office 365 Pro Plus and minimize cost. You need to standardize corporate device deployment. Which three actions should you perform? Option A, implement Windows Autopilot. Option B, deploy policies by using Configuration Manager. Option C, upgrade all devices to Windows 10. Option D, deploy policies by using Microsoft Intune. Option E, instruct users to download and install a Windows installer package for Office 365 Pro Plus. The correct answers are Option A, implement Windows Autopilot. Option C, upgrade all devices to Windows 10. Option D, deploy policies by using Microsoft Intune. Question number 20. A company deploys Microsoft 365. You notice improvements that can be made to some Microsoft 365 services. You need to submit a formal feature request to Microsoft with your suggestions for improvement. Which tool should you use? Option A, Microsoft Office Support Site. Option B, Security and Compliance Center. Option C, Microsoft 365 Roadmap Site. Option D, Feedback Hub App. Option E, User Voice Site. The correct answer is Option D, Feedback Hub App.